Good evening. I'm Pastor David Maier, and I'm privileged to serve as the president of the Michigan District of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod. This is the Hope is Here End of Day Closing. It's meant to give an encouraging, reassuring word almost every weeknight, and currently features hymns that have been arranged with various instrumentations from the Hymnal Project. The Hymnal Project may be accessed on the Michigan District website, michigandistrict.org, and is a free resource. Thanks to everyone, musicians, producers, contributors, and to good friend Peter Prochnow, all of whom make this resource possible. It is our prayer that after you join us, your heart and mind would be quieted, retuned, encouraged, and filled with the good gifts of God, and that you might leave humming or singing a great hymn. So turn off the news, stop messaging with friends, gather your family together for these very few minutes, listen and meditate. Before I get into the text of this evening's hymn, My Faith Looks Up to Thee, Lutheran Service Book number 702, I want you to know that this hymn is a thoroughly American hymn penned by Ray Palmer in 1830. In fact, this is one of the most famous hymns from American history, even used as a source of encouragement and serenity by Civil War soldiers on both sides. Two men, Ray Palmer, a doctor of theology, and Lowell Mason, a doctor of music, met in Boston in 1830. Mason inquired of Palmer if he had any lyrics that could be inserted for spiritual songs for social worship, a compilation that was being prepared by Mason and Thomas Hastings for publication. Palmer presented Mason his leather book containing his poem, My Faith Looks Up to Thee, originally in six stanzas. It wasn't until Mason arrived home that evening that these celebrated stanzas of My Faith Looks Up to Thee were read. He was impressed, inspired, and immediately wrote the tune Olivet, the only melody ever performed with Palmer's poem. Palmer believed his hymn flourished since it, and I now quote directly, embodied in appropriate and simple language that which is most central to all true Christian experience, the act of faith in the divine Redeemer, the entrusting of the individual soul to Him entirely and forever. Friends, our souls rest, for rest within our nation from the COVID-19 virus, and for peace among the citizens of our land amidst the history of injustices that have been so long tolerated or excused, we need to fix our eyes and our faith on Jesus. Listen to the first stanza. My faith looks up to thee, thou Lamb of Calvary, Savior divine. Now hear me while I pray. Take all my guilt away. Oh, let me from this day be wholly thine. And who of us does not need God's grace to impart each day the strength we need to live the Christian life for the welfare of our neighbor and the glory of God? Listen to the prayer in stanza 2 and its total reliance on what only God can give. May thy rich grace impart strength to my fainting heart, my zeal inspire. As thou hast died for me, O may my love to thee be pure, warm, and changeless be, a living fire. We should remember well the encouragement of Hebrews chapter 12, verses 2 and 3. Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, for the joy that was set before him, he endured the cross, scorning its shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinners, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. The remaining two stanzas deal with life's difficult moments and seasons, and when in fact the final enemy, death, is faced. While life's dark maze I tread, and griefs around me spread, be thou my guide, bid darkness turn to day, wipe sorrow's tears away, nor let me ever stray from thee aside. When ends life's transient dream, when death's cold sullen stream shall o'er me roll, blessed Savior, then in love, fear and distrust remove. O bear me safe above, a ransomed soul. Because we are purchased and won by the Savior Jesus, we have the privilege each day of studying His Word, drawing close to Him for strength and wisdom for daily living, and living from a faith that looks to Jesus alone. Please listen to, sing along with, and meditate upon My Faith Looks Up to Thee, Lutheran Service Book number 702, done in a rhythm and blues vocals and piano version.
Up to thee, O land of Calvary, Savior divine. Now hear me while I pray, take all my guilt away. Oh, let me from this day be wholly thine. May Thy rich grace impart strength to my fainting heart, my zeal inspire. As Thou hast died for me, oh, may my love to Thee pure, warm, and changeless be a living fire. While life's dark maze I tread, and grief around me spread, be Thou my guide. Bid darkness turn to day, wipe sorrow's tears away, nor let me ever stray from Thee aside. When ends life's transient dream, when death's cold sullen stream shall o'er me roll, blessed Savior, then in love fear and distrust remove. Oh, hear me safe above a ransomed soul.
Friends, please join me in prayer as we approach the Father's throne in the name of Jesus. Gracious Father, we thank You for the privilege of praying to You in the name of the one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus. Jesus, we thank You for Your life, Your perfect life, Your innocent death on Calvary's cross, and for the payment that is made for all sin, for all guilt, for all time. And we pray that You would ever make us mindful of the redemption that is ours by grace through faith, the faith the Holy Spirit has worked within us. May our faith ever look up to You, Lamb of Calvary. We pray that we would know that You are not only our Savior, but our brother, our friend, our companion, and that through the Holy Spirit, You continue to grant us daily wisdom. Help us, dear Lord, to face each day's trial with Your presence and power, that we can deal with all the difficulties of the COVID-19 crisis, of reopening, as it is said, within the United States. And we pray, dear Lord, that You would help us to overcome the injustices in our nation by being a part of the solution and not pointing fingers. Lord, this day, we also want to pray for the New Jersey District of the Lutheran Church Missouri Synod. Be with its leader, its pastors, its congregants, its schools, that they can be bright, shining lights of the gospel, of the healing good news of Jesus Christ crucified and risen for all. All of us, we bring before Your throne of mercy and grace, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. Friends, sing in your heart to God, remembering what He has already done for you, and that He is able to do far more abundantly than all we ask or imagine, according to the power that works within us. So let's ask, imagine, and hope for our family, friends, community, and country. Remember that because of Jesus, the best is always yet to come. Good night.